Good evening. My name is Maria. I am going to be your consultant today. I wanted to welcome you to our Book Lovers Club, and I'm so happy to congratulate you for joining it. You do get the free demonstration session, which is going to be handled by me, where you can pick any books that you enjoy or are looking for, and I will demonstrate them to you. I will show you different secrets and different places that you might be interested in those books. So, I do know that you are looking for a book, a gift book for a young person, right? Okay, so I would assume you're looking for something with more graphic pictures, with brighter colors and more interesting photographs, right? Okay, so I do have some in mind, but do you have any particular ones that you're looking for? Oh, you do. Okay, so why don't you tell me the names of them, and I'll go and find them just for you. Okay, we do have them all in here in the room, so it wouldn't take me long, but I want you to be patient with me, please. And we're trying to keep it down still here, because even though it's just a bookstore, it's kind of like a library. Okay, so what's the first book's name? Secrets of Simplicity. Okay, very good. Do you know the author's name? Okay. Okay, by Mary Carlomagno. Okay, very well, thank you. What is the second book? Safari. By Gail Kaufman. Okay. Alright, the third one. The Godfather. Alright, good choice. It's a very good collector's book. You'll see why. Yes. The Godfather. And that's the archives, right? Okay. So it's the And the fourth one is The Wonders of the World. Okay, Wonders of the World. Okay, very well. So let me take this list with me, and let me just make sure that I got all of the names right. Okay, and I'll go real quick and I'll get to these.
Alright, so let me show you the list.
And over you here, if you don't mind. Okay. So this is the list that I have. So it's the Secrets of Simplicity here. Then I have Safari, The Godfather, and The Wonders of the World, just like you asked, right? Okay. Alright. So let's start with the first one. That's the Secrets of Simplicity. Let me find that one for you. 1 second. We do have all of them here in this room 100%, so I need to be looking for them. Let me check on the shelf and just see. I wonder. No, this is not it. Let me check on this shelf here. Okay, here it is. Yep. Very well. So, yeah. This is the first book that we had on the list, The Secrets of Simplicity, by this author here. Okay, so, now let me find Safari. I think it's on that side. Let me check. Let me check here. It should be here. Alright, let me see.
big graphic book. Safari one, don't you just love this? Look, it, you can already see some of the imagery being like having an action movement to it. So it is a particular book. I'm sure you're gonna enjoy this truly. I think it looks great. So the next one we have. This is the Godfather book, as I told you. It's very popular with young adults, so to say. And the last one is Wonders of the World. Okay, one second, I think it's on that side.
Should be somewhere here. So now we are definitely all set, because this is the Wonders of the World book. Alright, so now let me take my place, and I'm going to go through some of these books for you, and just demonstrate you to them, okay? Okay, we're going to start our demonstration with this first book by the name Safari. This book has a lot of texture to it, as you can tell. It's actually of a texture of alligator skin, and then it's black colored, and then on top we have a sign written in gold that says Safari, like that, very charmingly done. On the top we have some colorings that is orange and black that goes throughout the book. Continues on the back as well, sort of in a tiger African style. We have more engravings. Let's see Safari on the back here. And we have some feedback and some words about the book itself in the back of it. So it says, "The magical journey, a safari in your hand. Animals in living motion, as real as if you were there. The cheetah bounds, the lion charges, the African elephant snaps its ears. Using unique particular technology, a safari is the adventure of a lifetime. In a book unlike any other, experience it for yourself." It's truly a wonderful book. Is pretty thick, as it seems like, although in actuality each page is much thicker than it's supposed to be because of the effect that the image creates when movement is made. So let's start the review. As you open the top cover, you realize that this top cover or tab page, controls the movements and the speed of the image on the bottom. So here right away we have the word Safari. Then if we flip it, we get to introduction that tells us of how this book was created, by whom, why, what's the purpose of it, etc. Then we get to the description of the cheetah that we just saw on the previous page. Here we have a sweet lion that's very interesting. I do think that this kind of a book would be great, not only for children, but for adults, or just young adults as well, just for fun, just because you can control the speed of the motion of the image here. And additionally, you get all of this information about the habitat, the diet, the population, the location of the maturity of these animals, and that's something that is very vital. That's something that we all need to know. At the same time, it's pretty funny, because if I move the top of the book slow, for example, this gorilla, too slowly. If I go faster, he starts to chew really quickly, which is very adorable and very cute in my opinion. I think it would be a great book for children, because they will pay more attention to the bottom and to an actual image of an animal as you read them the description of its life and the sizes and the habitat and all of the needed information that they don't need to know. So if you're trying to introduce somebody to the world of African animals, of safari, this is the way to go. Here we have a cute elephant flapping his ears. And a couple more animals here. So again, this book, I think, is a great book for a gift. Not only because of its textures and the pictures, but because it's just very interesting. It's a great conversation piece. It's a great icebreaker. And it's just a great thing, for example, for a coffee table, when you have your guests, something for them to get entertained by. That's this one. Now we're moving on to a darker type of a book, which is The Godfather. And I have to say that this book should be the best collector's choice, especially for people who enjoy mobster or crime movies, such as The Godfather. Something about mafia and killing people and stuff like that. The true collectors will really appreciate this one, I'm sure. So as we open it up, we start with this bloody red color. And everything is sort of in dark coloring, specifically, you know, to give you that mood of the mobster movie. Then you see the content, the description, with a number of pages. And with the description of each page, of what you will receive and what you will see on that page. As we start flipping through it, we start getting a lot of insights of this play itself, how it has been made. You get some examples and copies of the actual screenplay, as well as some shots from the scenes involving very famous actors and actresses that were a part of that movie. And then you get these surprise pockets, sort of enclosures. And then this one we have four different enclosures. So we get the three cue sheets used in the production of the film. Then we get a special brochure from the Journal of Dental. We get an internal memo about the transfer of the daily rushes between Sicily and Hollywood. And we get some pages of dialogues, of actual scripts. So I will demonstrate you this one. the rest of them, you'll need to get the book and see for yourself what other surprises you might get, okay? So, as I take this out, you can already see that these are copies of this. This is the copy of the dialogue scripts. If you put left change, you can see actual dialogues from the movie. From The Godfather. How incredible is it to have it, to go through it, to show it off? Then we get the cue sheets. Yeah, there's a bunch of these. All handwritten, which is a treasure. Then those are the dailies from Sicily to Hollywood. Okay. And some lists of things used and how many of each needs to be used in the movie. And all handwritten again. The last thing is the dental survey with pictures of actual teeth moldings that were used in the movie for some of the actors. It's a little bit gross, but it's very good to know. Very interesting to see that. Because you don't always get to see the behind the scenes specials, you know, in this way. You can see how this historic movie has been created and have a part of it for yourself. And as we continue, once again, we would be getting more insights into the movie, more extras, more interesting facts, some pictures of the backgrounds used, more surprises, more shots of the crew and the staff and behind the scenes shots, some descriptions, some surprises, I'm sure, some reactions to actual premiere, insights of how everything was happening back then, another enclosure. And then, when we're finished with the book, you'll be able to receive a poster for each part of the movie. It has three posters. As you can see, it's for one of them. You get it for all three parts. Part one, well, The Godfather, then part two and part three. So, and on the back, obviously, you get a picture of the Godfather with the bride and some descriptions of how everything was involving around that movie, around this book as well, how it, like how long it all took, and just quick insight into the book, just the introduction. Okay, so that's that, that's the Godfather. Now I'm gonna show you two more books. If you don't mind, I will be standing over you like this, so you can hear me a little bit better. So now we have two more books left. I have Wonders of the World here and Secrets of Simplicity. We'll start with this beautiful, it's pretty heavy book that's called Wonders of the World. As we open it up, we start with this black blank top. And now with this mirrored in the water image, with the mirrored name here as well, Wonders of the World. We get to the contents, and we have all of the pages numbered here, numbered, with the description of each particular wonder of the world assigned to a specific page. Introduction. we can track the wonders of the world at. You can see that all of the major continents are present, obviously. We have Australia right here. We have Asia. We have Europe assigned. Africa. We have South America, Central America, and North America. And then you see these little flipped triangles, sort of a thing. And these are actually the particular points of where the wonder is located. So for example, here we can see number 27 is, let me see on the chart here, it's the Metropolitan Cathedral in Brazil. So that would be right here. And let's find something on the other side. For example, number 21, and that is the Taj Mahal in India. So you see it's much easier this way to follow the wonders of the world and pinpoint them on the world's map. So that's pretty interesting. United States, here we have a couple. For example, we have the Experience Music Project in Seattle, United States, which is number 36 right here. Then in Australia, we have, that's number 28. We have this Opera House in Sydney, Australia. So, as you can see, all of them are going to be pinpointed like this, which is very wonderful. And now moving on, we're going to start with the pyramids in Egypt. And there's not really much words that I can describe my feelings with you about my understanding of the pyramids. I am just fascinated by it. They are built around 2575 BC, so it's before Jesus Christ. So these structures have withstand high winds, crucial sun exposures, rain, anything that she can think of, and they all still look just incredible. All of the textures, all of the details, all of the things that are carved with stone have been standing for thousands of years. And I think that the any country really that has an ancient artifact like that is just priceless. I am so proud of those people, and I appreciate their hard work in keeping these structures safe and sound for the future generations to come, so that they can appreciate the beauty and all of the architecture, all of the beautiful details, beautiful stone and woodwork, anything. Here we have the Mayan city. This is in Turkey. So you can see the beautiful pictures, the graphics of this book are just incredible. This is in Italy. This is Italy as well, as you can see. All of the wonderful details. So much sweat, so much work, so much thought is put into these beautiful pieces. And so much care, so much determination, so much resources. This is the Great Wall. in China. And so let me read some of it about it. How long is it, I wonder? Okay. It is stretching for more than 3,100 miles or 5,000 kilometers. That should tell you something. I hope it protected their nation from whatever they were trying to hide from. And again, that wonderful picture in the mountains there. Let's flip through. You have the Vatican City. And let's move on to the more modern marvels, such as Eiffel Tower, the most romantic place on earth, the symbol of love. Empire State Building, I'm sure we all remember. Godzilla, I'm sorry. King Kong, I apologize. Climbing on it like that, on this tower, all the way up. And then he was trying to protect his loved one, and then he tragically fell. Very touching. And in the end, we have more of the modern marvels and more of the modern beautiful museums and airports, amazing structures, such as these towers. This book is very organized. As you can see, it has these little tabs that take you to different chapters of the book, like this. So let's read a couple of quotes. The first chapter would be journey over 1,000 miles begins with a single step.